fascinated by everybody around here, walking around, how enthusiastic they are about films. Of course, we work on many films and we're in the background, but it's fascinating how people now know about our side of the of filmmaking, which is the technical side behind the camera.
For any fans who might not be familiar with the astonishing body of work that you're responsible for, can you just maybe introduce yourself and tell us just some of the fantastic projects that you've worked on?
Well, this is a very difficult thing to say, because I've done things like the Rocky Horror Picture Show, and then Superman, Supergirl, a couple of Bonds, Aliens, and of course Batman. And I've done about, in my career, about 82 films since I started the industry. So it's been quite a long journey for me. But I now teach young people the film industry at Pinewood Film Studio, so I quite enjoy that. It's a lovely thing to do. Hand back a little bit of what I'd learnt, handing it back into the industry, which I think is lovely.
For anyone who's not familiar with kind of movie vernacular, can you perhaps just explain a little bit about exactly what the responsibilities of an art director are on a project?
Yeah, the responsibility is basically finding locations, it's designing all the sets, it's coming up, helping the director with ideas, and you really work at that with a director. From a script, you decide what a certain thing's going to look like. Like Tim Burton, when we were doing the Batman, he's a very dark director, he likes things very dark. So our colours had to be different. Then you can do same director doing Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. It's all very bright and colourful.
Rocky Horror Picture Show, that's a film that really has a devoted audience. And such an iconic look, I think, particularly in terms of the sets. I mean, it very much was a beautiful kind of homage to the classic kind of silver screen, sort of Dr. Frankenstein-style laboratories. Can you talk a little bit about working on that very special project?
Well, I mean, first of all, they were all odd people for me, because I'm quite an ordinary-looking guy, but I got on very well with them all. I think Brian was a sort of a director that had amazing ideas, and then we just put them in operation. And it's the way that he is, he was, and he did the show, of course, and then he was doing this the film of it. And we used an old house called Oakley Court, which is now a hotel, but I mean at that particular time. Great film, and you almost could do anything, and they accepted it, you know, it was good. They had great ideas. I mean, on the film we had, you know, in the auditorium, we had deck chairs. Well, I didn't think of the deck chairs, but the director said we put deck chairs because I put all theatre seats in it. And he said, I don't want them, let's have some deck chairs. So I got the deck chairs, but we made them all red and white. You know, this is just to help the colour of the set.
It's a beautiful looking film, but why do you think it remains such a devoted cult classic?
Well, I think what happens is that I think that the show was so successful and it was a bit eccentric, as it were. I know that, for instance, I was in Las Vegas and the courier that found out that I'd done the film, because the film was on a cinema, stopped it and I got the key to Las Vegas for the day. It was amazing because it's a cult industry. And I mean, if you get, it's still being shown today, of course. And it's, if you go and see the film, where we had the rain sequence, they throw rice to give the same effect. You can't put water around on a cinema, but you can do rice.
I mean, Superman is a franchise and a character that changed the landscape of cinema in many ways. You know, we really believed a man would fly. Can you talk a little bit about working on that?
Well, I didn't do Superman 1, but I did do 2 or 3, etc. Christopher Reeves, I got very friendly with anyway. We all did, really, as film units you do. Flying was one of those very, very difficult things to do, because how do you make the man look as if he's flying? Well, we had all, I can't tell you all the secrets of it, but it's that was fascinating. I went to New York and Chicago to do all the aerial photography stuff with a guy called David Lane.
You've worked on brilliant films that were largely driven by practical effects. I mean, fantastic examples of The Labyrinth and Dark Crystal. How do you feel the advent of CGI has changed the industry? And do you think it's enhancing or detracting from the magic of cinema?
I think it's detracting, but then I'm old-fashioned, I suppose. But I just think that CGI takes the reality out of it a little bit. You know, it's a little bit like a like those game computer games and that sort of thing. To me, it does. Sometimes it works, but a lot of times I don't think it does.
Talking about practical effects, I think there's no film that really pushed the boat out more in that respect than The Dark Crystal. I mean, an astonishing fantasy production, and just visually so evocative, I think, just beautiful to look at. Can you talk, I mean, obviously Brian Froud, as a conceptual artist, was very involved in that, but can you talk a little bit about how you felt working on a project that magnificent?
Well, I think, first of all, that we had two directors, which was Jim Henson and Frank Oz, and Brian Froud was basically the concept artist on the film. That didn't, you know, just his ideas of it. And we worked basically from his ideas, but to make it, to give the feel of it, you know, all the mystics. I mean, it's a wholly a puppet picture.
Worked on Muppets as well, literally with The Great Muppet Caper. I mean, what are the specific challenges when it comes to working with that level of puppetry? In terms of, I mean, specifically set construction, I'd imagine, must be a nightmare.
Well, the sets were always built up about 4'6" on a big podium rostrum, if you like, so that the puppeteers could be standing up doing all their work. So in that respect, that's the big difference. Everything, I mean, obviously it was obviously full life human beings in it as well as the puppets. I think one of the biggest things on The Muppet Caper was one sequence which was a bit of a headache to begin with, was Miss Piggy and Kermit cycling in,
yeah.
Right? And they, Jim wanted it, Miss Piggy and Kermit to do a figure eight round each other. And he came up with the idea of a golf cart. And I suggested, well, maybe we ought to have a crane. You know, like a big crane. It was called the Iron Fairy, which can take any amount of weight. And we put platforms and the puppeteers could be up on it as well. And they just, that was actually with strings, that sequence was. But we went to New York. I made all the bicycles, or we did them. And then we had to go to New York to do the radio-controlled Kermit and Miss Piggy on them. So they'd, Couldn't We Ride was the name of the song.
Fans would probably want to know, is there one in particular that you feel most proud of, that you think represents your finest work?
I can't tell you how many times I'm asked that question. The thing is that what I feel is that the most enjoyable film that I ever worked on probably was a film called The Deep. Who wouldn't like being around the Caribbean for a year, diving and things, you see. So that was a fantastic thing. But the most successful film, I probably would think Batman. And the other thing I think was that after Batman, I would think the Rocky Horror, because that's a classic and everybody knows that. I would think, you know, but I mean, so many films I can't really say. I enjoy every film I work on.
What initial advice would you give to people looking to follow in your footsteps, particularly in terms of production and set design and getting into the industry behind the camera?
Just to be very, very patient and work bloody hard at it, and you will make it. I did. I worked hard at it, and then you start getting respect. It's still fun at the same time. So it's that chemistry that works well with, you know, with everybody that you work with. Like Alec next to me now is, it was on one or two films I've worked with him on as a lighting cameraman. You just got to have fun with everybody, you see.